Good morning to everyone. As the president of, excuse me, I don't know which is, this one. Yes. As the president of the Society of Argentinian Anthropology, I deeply thank the WAC and to his president, Dr. Koji Misoguchi, for his kind invitation. Our society was created in 1936, so this year is its 18th anniversary. Therefore, our society has witnessed many changes in the development of anthropology and archaeology of the world, including the creation of the World Archaeological Congress. The society congregates about 600 members, including professionals in anthropological sciences and students of their careers. It is a civil association that has a biannual publication, Relaciones Journal, and a publishing series of books, including PhD and undergraduate theses and research productions. The convening of this plenary takes us back to 1986, after the full return to democracy and to the gradual opening of the institutionalized investigation in Argentina. It also brings us to positive changes and setbacks in Latin American political situations and their influence on the science policy that I'll try to tell you something about them. Before that, our country was immersed in one of the worst dictatorships in our history, which, among many other vexations, resulted in a major genocide framed in the imprisonment, torture, disappearance, and death of political and social activists. This led to a new global legal concept known as missing, and also led to a particular way of doing archaeology focused on finding people in clandestine detention centers or in massive graves in cemeteries, which still continues. Thus, it was formed in 1984, the Argentine Forensic Anthropological Team, that recently turned 30 years of existence in 2014, whose specificity and vast experience has helped it clarify crimes against humanity in various countries. Also, during the civic military dictatorship occurred the closing of anthropology and archaeology careers at various universities in the country, as Mar del Plata, Buenos Aires, Rosario, some of which never reopened. Return to democracy in 1984, the scientific system was reopened and many young graduates could enter the CONICET and university and start a career as researchers. The decade of the 90s under neoliberal governments brought us to a decline in state support for scientific research, which resulted in the migration of thousands of scientists to other countries in search of better horizons, including many social scientists. Those who remained doing archaeological research were witnesses of victims of research career closed at CONICET and reducing jobs. An important turning point in the course of archaeological work is the one that relates to the claims of the indigenous peoples on cultural heritage and especially regarding human remains of their ancestors worldwide. It was in the First World Archaeological Congress in Southampton in 1986 that discussions between researchers and indigenous representatives took place, which resulted in the Vermilion Agreement, pointing fundamental aspects of mutual respect and agreements to be reached in the exercise of our discipline and its relationship with indigenous people. The Native American Graves Protection and Repatriation Act was also approved in 1990. In Argentina, it coincides with the enactment of Law 23302 on indigenous policy and support to indigenous communities, which recognizes their legal status. In 1990, the National Institute of Indigenous Affairs is created, which began to register indigenous communities who are granted legal status. In those years, our country adheres to OIT Convention 1961-69, and the National Constitution is redrafted in 1994, whose Article 75 recognizes the ethnic and cultural preexistence of Argentine indigenous peoples, ensuring respect for their identity and guaranteeing their participation in the management of their natural resources and other interests affecting them. This promoted the interest and the claim of indigenous peoples about their past and especially the remains of their ancestors' cultural heritage. Thus arose the first orders for the return of remains of known identity, most of them deposited in the Museo de la Plata. This promoted organizational processes in the indigenous population, as well as the interest and the claim about his past. Thus, the first claims for the return of human remains of known identity arose and were implemented, most deposited, as I said, in La Plata Museum. In 2001, law 25,517 was enacted, which generated a substantial change in the matter, stating that museums should make available to indigenous peoples and communities of belonging that claim human remains of aborigines who form part of the collections, and also that every scientific undertaking that has to do with aboriginal communities, including their historical and cultural heritage, should account with the express consent of the community concerned. This law was regulated by Decree 701 of 2010, which states that the National Institute of Indigenous Affairs is empowered to conduct surveys aimed to identify the remains of aborigines who are part of museums and or public or private collections and encourage restitution. Meanwhile, several statements have been issued, as the ones you see in the diapo, where agreements about no display of human remains in museums and guidelines regarding the rights of indigenous peoples over the biological remains of their ancestors and heritage assets within a framework of mutual collaboration for further research with the consent of the parties were set up. In parallel, the National Council of Research and Technical Institution created in 2005 the Ethics Committee as an interdisciplinary advisory body on ethical and bioethical aspects related to the development of scientific activities. In this sense, Argentina has been pioneer respect to indigenous rights over their assets compared to other South American countries, I think. In 2009, the National Meeting of Indigenous Peoples for Territorial Organizations, called ENOTPO, was created as a space made up of 45 organizations that brings together 27 pre-existing populations and more than 1,500 communities, with representation in 20 provinces of Argentina. It is a propositional space that articulates indigenous territorial policy at national level. In 2014, the prior free and informed protocol was promulgated, in which the procedures enabling the effective participation of indigenous peoples at all levels of decision making in any process that affects them directly and potentially are established. Among these processes, archaeological and anthropological research are included. In connection with these developments regarding the treatment of cultural heritage of indigenous peoples, claiming ownership loss of their rights and the protocols of agreement and consent began to be held in 2011, the workshops of return of human remains of archaeological and biological interest, the TADIR. in order to discuss policies related to professional treatment of sites and repositories of mortal remains. The first workshops were restricted to professionals in archaeology, bioanthropology, and social anthropology, but over the last two celebrated ones, they were attended by representatives of indigenous nations of Argentina. Another outstanding aspect is the development of the Congress of Archaeological Theory of South America, ranging from its 18th edition. The TAS was born in Argentina in 1996, bringing together academics from various Latin American universities and international institutions like the World Archaeological Congress. The first meeting took place in Victoria in 1998, and subsequent meetings were organized, as you see there, in Olavarría, Bogotá, Catamarca, Caracas, Guyana, San Felipe, and the latest one in May of this year in La Paz, Bolivia. From 2009, the Dakar is being held in South America, as you know. It means destruction of both cultural heritages and traditions and an abuse of our natural environment. In countries like Chile and Peru, it was banned for proven damage to archaeological sites, environments, and settlements of local communities. In Argentina, although there have been many campaigns and statements against it, including one from the Society of Argentine Anthropology, yet we could not achieve DACA to be forbidden. As final remarks, I will tell that in the last 10 years, they have proliferated spaces for discussion and sharing of positions relating to archaeological practice and its relationship to the interest of the communities around which it develops in an intercultural dialogue. During the National Congresses of Argentina Archaeology, Argentine Archaeology, the embodiment of roundtables and symposiums on this subject has been consolidating, including archaeology and communities, archaeology and social movements, relationships, archaeology and human rights, public archaeology, among others, totaling 5 lots in the last congresses recently accomplished in the province of Tucumán 2 weeks ago, and involving archaeologists from neighboring countries such as Chile, Uruguay, and Brazil. All these reflects the long way that has been traveled in the last 30 years in the southern cone of America to give a future to the past, positioning on the issues of the present. Thank you.